Research is the process of discovering new knowledge. It's different than other forms of discovering knowledge, like reading a book, because it uses a systematic process called the scientific method. The scientific method is a multi-step process that begins with observation, where you define a research question. Once you have a question you want answered, you might develop a hypothesis as to what the answer is, then conduct an experiment and determine your study's conclusion. Research is generally published in medical journals and presented at scientific conferences. Publishing in journals and presenting at conferences is a way to communicate research so other scientists can review the study results. By journal, we're referring to academic magazines that publish research articles about health-related topics. These journals publish their articles online and sometimes also in print. Different journals tend to relate to particular academic disciplines like biology or physics. Our focus will be journals that publish information about medicine or healthcare. Authors of articles found in these journals are typically academics at universities with graduate degrees like PhDs, or clinicians like doctors, nurses, and pharmacists. Students training to acquire their master's and doctoral degrees also submit their thesis work to these journals. Patients, which we define as individuals with personal experience of a health issue, and informal caregivers, including family and friends, can also be authors or co-authors in healthcare journals. Now that we know what a journal is, let's talk about how they operate. Here's a quick overview of six broad steps involved in publishing in a medical journal. 1. Researchers start a study by writing a protocol. You can think of a protocol as a project plan or a recipe for all of the steps involved for conducting the study. Once the protocol is completed, sometimes researchers have to give various approvals, such as research ethics approval, before starting their study. They often also have to seek funding from grant agencies to have the necessary tools and personnel to do the work. 2. Once funding and approvals are in place, researchers conduct the study according to the protocol. When the study is done, they analyze the data and draft a report of their findings. This report is called a manuscript. 3. The researchers then select a journal to submit their manuscript in the hopes that the journal will publish it. Most journals specialize in different diseases, such as cancer or mental health, and topics such as breast cancer or research on health policy. Journals also have different policies for the types of studies they accept and different audiences, so the researchers need to choose their journal carefully. Once the researchers submit the manuscript to a journal, a person working at the journal, typically an editor, receives the manuscript and reviews it. The editor looks to see if the manuscript is a good fit for the journal, may discuss the manuscript with a colleague at the journal, and conduct some quality checks, such as ensuring the text is not plagiarized. The editor can choose to reject the manuscript or send it out for peer review. Peer-reviewed means that the manuscript is assessed by other experts in that field who are not connected to the authors of the manuscript. These reviewers provide unbiased feedback on the strengths and weaknesses of the manuscript. Based on the review, the editor will either reject the manuscript or request that the researchers respond to the peer reviewer's comments by adjusting their paper. If changes are requested, the manuscript may be reviewed again. 5. If an editor decides to accept a manuscript, it goes through copy editing. Then the journal publishes the manuscript. A published manuscript is called an article. Researchers want to share their research in journals to contribute to the overall body of knowledge available to the scientific community and patients. Colleagues can then reproduce and expand on the knowledge. The result is advancement of the overall field. Publication provides recognition within the field for the author and builds a reputation as a researcher. Also, by publishing in a journal which uses peer review and has publication policies to ensure quality, the work can be considered to have been verified independently. Journals also ensure that articles are indexed or available in databases and preserved on reliable websites so that others interested in the topic can easily search these and find relevant information in the future. There are two main formats journals publish research articles. The first format, which is the oldest, is through subscription-based journals. The researchers pay nothing to publish, but people who want to read the article must pay a fee. Many universities and research institutions buy subscriptions to journals so their staff can have access to them. This means that patients would have to pay to read this material. The second main format of publishing is called open access. In this model, researchers often have to pay money to have the journal publish their accepted article. This money, called an article processing charge, helps to pay for the journal's operations and for the copy editing of the article. Paying this fee makes the research publicly available so anyone can access and read the work without having to pay. This model is considered to be more equitable since there are no barriers for people who wish to access the research.